Hi, I'm Antonio Centeno. I'm the founder of Real Men, Real Style. Today I'm going to be answering a reader's question, and he emailed me back and he's, hey Antonio, I'm working with a tailor and I find that it's really difficult to communicate with him. He made me a custom jacket, didn't turn out exactly how I wanted. Is there a way that I can better talk to him, better communicate with the gentleman here who's making my clothing? Now, about once a month, I hear these horror stories. Somebody worked with an online custom clothier, somebody worked with their local tailor, and it just did not come out right. They took their clothing, their shirt, to a seamstress, and she basically tore it apart. They look at it and they're like, oh, this is not what I imagined. So in today's video, I'm gonna be talking about how you can better communicate with your tailor so that you get what you want and you avoid that frustration and wasted money, okay? So before we get into this, guys, you know what I'm gonna ask you? Please subscribe to the channel. That way these videos come right to you. In addition, if you want more, if you really like this stuff, let me know down in the comments. We interact with people down there, and if you like this video, please like it. Okay, so number one, when communicating with a tailor, and actually before we get into that, why does this matter? Well, whenever you have poor communication between you and a seamstress, tailor, a custom clothing shop, you're gonna find that mistakes are usually due to miscommunication. It's not like they're purposely trying to ruin your new suit or, you know, tear this up. I mean, they don't want to do this. So it is almost always due to miscommunication. In addition, it costs both parties. You think it costs you money. Well, if you're the tailor, you're actually having to go back and spend, redo this, not only tear it apart, but then you're hoping that the customer's not gonna want their money back, and you're gonna have to either, if you have a return policy or you don't, you're gonna have to decide what happens next. In addition, the relationship. To be honest, most clothing companies, we want return customers. Maybe there's one or two out there that I don't know of that don't want this, but I can tell you it's return customers who are happy, who pass on our company to other people by word of mouth. That is how we build a legitimate business. So we do not want to ruin the relationship. So number one, when you're communicating with a tailor, get it in writing. Now, I'm not saying that you have to have them sign a contract, but what I am saying, if you're giving them a lot of things that you want, make sure that it is not only perhaps in an email, but everything is summarized. I like to use Google Docs. I've also seen it where you actually have, you know, a written, if it's a good organized company, they're actually gonna have a form in which you're gonna fill out, or they're gonna fill out for you exactly what you're asking for. You wanna have it in one place. Having it in multiple emails is not, it's okay, but it will lead to confusion, because basically the more items that we're having to look at, the more confusing it's going to be. So try to have it in one document. I recommend Google Docs, or if the company is organized, they should have a sheet. So oftentimes if you work with a traveling tailor, he's actually going to have a full sheet and you'll be able to see and look at what he's writing down. Ask for a copy of it. Take your smartphone, take a quick picture of that, so that if there is a discretion, if you asked for vented, you asked for a certain type of pocket, slanted pockets, that you can actually say, hey, I've got this right here, remember, and there's not gonna be any type of confusion because it's clearly right there, black and white. Okay, so number two is have them basically send it back to you. And this is what I was talking about when, make sure you get a copy of the receipt. Make sure that you have some way that they have agreed that this is exactly. And so that's where maybe taking the smartphone picture with your signature on it or something like that. The best I've ever seen a gentleman do this, Bobby Naren, he runs Naren Couture over in Bangkok. I remember talking to him, he was building out a suit for me, and he listened, he wrote it out, and then he actually sketched out what he was going to build for me. To me, that is the mark of an amazing craftsman. And by the way, I highly recommend Naren Couture over in Bangkok. He's a good friend, and that guy is, I think, one of the best tailors in all of Southeast Asia, if not the best. So he basically drew it out, and that is, in a sense, what you want is to make sure that they understood what you were talking about. Again, you're getting this in writing, so it's very similar to number one. And number three, keep it simple. So if this is the first order with a new tailor, or the first time you're taking a shirt to a seamstress to get it adjusted, only take one item. Do not take her 10 shirts and get them all adjusted only to find out that she didn't understand this and that she brought them in way too much, and you put on the shirts and you look like it's skin tight on you, and that is not the look you want. No, start off small, keep it simple. If you're working with a custom clothier, I understand some custom clothiers want you to buy a package. Well, start off with one jacket and one shirt. They should all, they shouldn't make the entire order for you. You want to have that one item because it's a lot easier to fix one item than it is to go back and try to fix three jackets or five jackets or 10 shirts. Okay, last thing, this is kind of a bonus one, guys, is check the return policy and how they work with refunds and things like that before you buy, before you hand over the money. Once you hand over the money, and I'd have to say, you know, I'd like to say that my industry is one in which everyone always honors their word, but when it comes down to it, once you've handed over the money, there are some less than respectable vendors out there, and they have a no return policy. They understand this is a custom product and they are not going to take a loss on this. And they're not scared that you're going to write a bad review. I know that's something that you can go back. You don't want the relationship to deteriorate to that point. And you want to make sure, and in my opinion, whenever I'm going to recommend a company or if I'm going to talk about them or if I'm even going to deal with them, I always make sure they've got a good return policy because to me, that's the hallmark of a solid company. Again, over-communicate with your tailor. If you're watching this and you're a tailor, try to always over-communicate with your client and use local if possible. So that's a really nice thing. If you can actually go in and face-to-face meet with your tailor or your seamstress. Some of you guys, I know you're maybe in rural areas and it's going to be hard to be able to find someone good locally, but it is something that if you can work locally, do it. Okay, guys? All right. So take care. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.